they're poor people in terms of money, what we relate to richness, yeah. They don't have much money. They don't have a lot of resources. At the same time, they have a huge privilege. And they live in the middle of paradise, and I think they realize that in terms of they love the place where they live.
Yo soy pescador y soy nacido y criado aquí, en la isla de Boca Chica. De chiquito estamos metidos pescando. Vemos los mayores pescando y de ahí también nosotros nos vamos con ellos y vemos cómo ellos hacen y de ahí uno se va.
When you see the water quality, so brown water, brackish water, you don't think there is a reef below those waters. The local fishermen, those who live from the reef on a daily basis, they knew very well about this reef.
Hemos tenido un arrecife que es el que más ha durado, que es el que tenemos del frente, que ustedes están visitando, que es el que ha sostenido, ha resistido toda clase de contaminación que le ha pasado y está vivito.
It's at the entrance of one of the most polluted bay of Colombia and Latin America. So I thought, yeah, of course it's not going to be a reef there. So when I jumped in and I start seeing like some corals and then a reef, and it never ended.
It's really murky and turbid, and then as you go through this layer, there is a higher visibility, and then there's this massive colonies, and this coral cover is super high, and there is high diversity. It's a very strange feeling because if something doesn't seem quite right, for something like that to be there. I feel almost at times that I'm like in a different planet. Initially, it started as a very basic science kind of project. My NSF grant with Becky Vega Thurber at Oregon State is to look at the coevolution between corals and microbes. The reef here in this bay probably has a very different microbiome than a normal reef in clear waters.
In the textbooks, coral reefs do really well in deep blue, crystal clear waters. There shouldn't be a reef there, but the reef is there. The reef is telling us there's something wrong with your books right now because we're doing well here. But what we want to know is how.
Right now, I don't have an answer. Like, I know these corals have some special adaptations that allow them to grow and to be like big, big colonies that you don't see as much as on other reefs in the Caribbean.
It's not only important to study it, but it's also important to protect it because we're trying to find these relics of reefs that are sturdy, that are very resilient, that are very robust against climate change and anthropogenic activities. And this seems to be one of them. And in the Caribbean, that's particularly important because the coral cover has been going down so quickly over decades. And the fact that this reef is doing so well provides a potential opportunity for reef restoration if these reefs can be used as seed to outplant to places where corals are gone.
we have a marine ecosystem that is unique in the Caribbean. You have this beautiful garden with everything that you always dream of. And you are just impressed and overwhelmed by its beauty. But it's right now facing a really big problem and is threatened because they want to destroy it.
The current developments that are threatening these reefs further, and not just this reef, but all the ecosystems associated with this bay, are a second navigation channel.
If they build their channel, they're gonna carve out a big chunk of this reef.
In this band that they must use to dredge this new channel, there are at least 10,000 coral colonies. And if the organisms associated to this reef also die with the dredging, the people that live from this reef will have a dramatic reduction in their life supplies.
Y a veces nosotros se nos cuantifica de no tenemos para comprar un kilo de carne, no tenemos para comprar un kilo de pollo. Es algo natural que nos
In all honesty, they haven't had much. They had to learn how to take advantage of the environment, and they became fishermen, and that's how they derived their livelihood from these waters for centuries, and now they're about to lose that.
They just need a little bit of help, a little bit of more help from all the institutions, the government, the universities, just to improve their lives and continue living in such a paradise.
¿Cómo van a destruir una cosa que está ahí formada, que tiene muchos años? Si son protecciones de la costa, ¿cómo no lo van a desarmarla?
We will lose the biodiversity, and I'm almost sure that the fishermen that depend on this reef will lose a source of food, income, life.
Es un arrecife coralino heroico. Lo ha resistido todo. Ha resistido la contaminación, ha resistido la sedimentación, ha resistido las aguas turbias. Tiene que resistir ahora también, pero ahora nos toca a nosotros. Ahora somos nosotros los que tenemos que salir en su defensa, porque él no se puede mover. Su fortaleza es su belleza, el haber sobrevivido. Entonces tiene que ser un imperativo ético nuestro defenderlo.
I believe in the value of this reef. I believe that it is important to save it.